Hello friends, welcome back. In this lecture, we are going to see Ethernet 802.3. It is also called as Ethernet LAN or IEEE 802.3. Why it is called as Ethernet 802.3? Because IEEE standard has given the name 802 to the Ethernet LAN and it has been defined by the IEEE standard. What is an LAN? You should know LAN is an communication network connecting limited geographical area. Okay, it can be connection can be wired or wireless. It is very popular because it is easy to understand, easy to implement and easy to maintain, and also the cost required for the implementation is also very low. Here the data unit for transmission of data is going to be data unit for transmission is frame. Okay, and it operates at a physical and data link layer of OSI model. IEEE has produced many standards for LANs known as IEEE 802 standard. And what are that standards? See, IEEE 802.1, 3, 1, 2, 3 and 5. We are mainly in this lecture, we are mainly going to focus on 802.3, which is an Ethernet LAN. Okay. See, it uses different kind of topologies, like bus and star. It uses CSMA CD as a medium for access. What is CSMA CD? It is a carrier sense multiple access protocol with a collision detection. And you should also know it uses one persistent CSMA CD LAN. Means what? See, in this protocol, what happened when one station wants to send the data to the another station? Firstly, it listens or it senses the medium. When the medium is idle, means when the medium is empty, the data is going to be transferred. The data is going to be transferred. Okay. But what happened when the medium is not empty? But what happened when the medium is not empty? It waits for medium to be empty. And one more thing you should know. What happened when two different stations want to send the data at the same time? What happened? It senses the medium and it transfers the data. But there is a chances of collision. Collision can happen there. So to avoid that collision, what happened? The particular frame directly replies, particular frames immediately replies to the respective station that collision is happening. So it terminates the transmission path or the whatever the channel is there. And the procedure is repeated again. So it is called as one persistent CSMA CD LAN. Okay. There are actually two. One more thing you should know about the Ethernet is an Ethernet LAN is an. They are actually classified into two main categories. The first one is a classic Ethernet and the second is a switch Ethernet. Whereas in the classic Ethernet, it provides the data rate up to data rate between 3 to 10 Mbps. Okay, and in the switch Ethernet, it uses switch to connect two different stations in the respective LAN. The transfer rate in the Ethernet 802.3, it is up to 10 Mbps or it can be 100 Mbps or it can be above. Okay, the name Ethernet refers to obviously cable. There are different types of cabling techniques provided by the 802.3 Ethernet cable. What are that we are going to see here. See, you can see there are four different categories. First one is the IEEE 802.3. Next is 3A, 3I and 3J. One by one we will see what are they. See what happened in the 10 base 5. See, firstly we should know what is 10 base and 5. 10 is for, see, 10 it is a data rate. It is an data rate in Mbps. Whereas base is a baseband signal. And 5 is length limit per cable type. Okay. It refers to all of that, but means 10 base 2, 10 base 3 and 10 base 5. One by one we will see what are there. So 10 base 5 means obviously data rate is going to be 10 Mbps. Baseband signal is going to be used up to 500 meter. It support up to 5 means it is up for it support up to 500 meters. Whereas in the 10 base 2 it refers to the 200 meters. Whereas 10 base T means it is used for the twisted pair cables. Whereas 10 base 5 means it is used for the fiber optic cables. Okay. Sorry. One by one we will also see what kind of topologies are there used in this Ethernet cabling and what are the cables used for this Ethernet cabling. As you can see, 10 by 5 or IEEE 802.3 uses bus topology and it has thick coaxial cable and it was established in the year 1983. Whereas in the 10 base 2 it also uses bus topology but thin coaxial cable is used and it was implemented in the year 1985. Okay. Next is a 10 base T. It uses star topology and it uses UTP cable. UTP means what? Unshielded twisted pair cable. Okay. And was published in the year or implemented in the year 1990. Whereas IEEE 802.3J uses star topology and it uses cable which is fiber optic and it was implemented in the year 1993. So these are the different Ethernet cabling for 802.3. What is the frame for? We'll see the frame format for the 802.3. Okay. See, you can see this is a frame format. First is a preamble. See what happened? It is a starting field that provides an alert and a timing false for the transmission. Whereas in the SOF, what happened? It is a start of frame, contains the patterns of zeros and ones, but the last two frame has to be zeros, okay? It is ending with the zero, okay? And it is a start of frame. Next field is a destination address. Obviously, it is going to contain the destination address. Next is a source address. It contains the source address from the where the data is sent it. Next field is in data where actual data is going to be there and you can see the size is varying, means minimum up to 46 byte of data we can send or maximum up to 1500 byte of data we can send. Variable size field and it carries the actual data. Whereas CRC, it is a cyclic redundancy check and it is used for the error detection. So this is the fields of the frame used for the 802.3. Thank you. I hope you like my video and please don't forget to subscribe my channel.